Hi again, I'm Buzz the Bee, and today we've got another buzzword for you today. It's attack surface management. Let's start by talking about what an attack surface is. Imagine all the ways that cyber criminals can hack into your network. Connected devices, websites, applications, cloud infrastructure, basically anything that can be used to gain access to a company's system, the summation of all those things is known as your attack surface. Think of your business like a castle, like this one here. This one's mine. Well, it's the Queen Bee's castle, but I'm subletting a room. Anyways, the attack surface of this castle would be like the doors, windows, chimneys, and anywhere else someone could break in. I know what you're thinking. Buzz, just build a castle without any entrances. Wow, so smart. I wish me and anybody else in the whole world had thought of that already. Ha ha ha. It's necessary to have doors and stuff, so important things can come in and out. For businesses, this is sharing data and communicating with the world. Oh, hi Jerry, how's it going? All right, I'll see ya. Don't worry, I know him. Anyways, whenever you add something else onto your network, like new devices or applications, you create more entrances, and more, and more, and they all need to be defended. Whoa! How could you defend so many potential vulnerabilities? How do you even keep track of them all? That's called attack surface management, and it refers to the process of a business actively identifying and monitoring all potential attack vectors to reduce your risk level. To do it well, you want to be proactively finding vulnerabilities, so cyber criminals don't find them for you. When looking for vulnerabilities, cybersecurity experts look at a few key areas, defining your physical and digital attack surface. Physical meaning any threat to devices or hardware, and digital meaning anything from your website, social media accounts, software, cloud infrastructure, and basically anything connected to your network. Attack surface management is about keeping track of and fortifying these vulnerabilities. Whether it's the front door, good work, everyone. Or the door that you thought nobody even knew about. Why'd we even build this door? There's no shortage of entryways into your business. Cybercriminals will find them all, even the most odd or gross. Sometimes you can even learn from other cyber attacks experienced by yourself or other businesses in the past and use that knowledge to fortify your attack surface. Oh, I've seen this one before. Not this time. Dae Gohan! Doh! Dae go my ice cream. Attack surface management is important because you can't defend what you don't know about. A plan to manage your attack surface reduces the risk of a cyber attack. Oh, look, there's the queen. Wow, so majestic. So regal. Hello, Your Majesty. Building a plan and effectively managing your attack surface can be broken down into a few key steps. 1. Identify entrances. Scouring your network and business for vulnerable access points. 2. Assess risk level. Going through those vulnerabilities to measure the risk they pose. 3. Implement security. Take steps to mitigate the risk of these threats. This is done by implementing cybersecurity measures like password management, security training, antivirus software, network monitoring tools, and whatever else is needed. 4. Continue to stay on top of it. New entry points are created every day, so it's important to continuously monitor your situation. Cybersecurity threats to businesses are not going away, so the more you know about them and how to stop them, the better. That's why our hive only enlists the best bees to protect it. You need everyone in your organization involved in order to have strong security. Right, guys?